Hey everyone, Ben Jordan back here again with on the Schematica channel with a quick tip in Altium Designer in the schematic side today. This may seem a little bizarre to many engineers, but there is a feature in Altium Designer and in most good schematic tools, you can design things in a hierarchy. So you can have sheets within sheets, pages within pages, and put things together either bottom up or top down in a hierarchical structure. And that's what we're looking at right here on my screen. I have a reference design. This is actually the old Nanoboard 2. And you can see there's a bunch of different schematic sheets, and it just helps break things up into bite-sized manageable chunks. But you might be looking at this wondering, what on earth are these schematic sheets with these recycling symbols on them? And these are actually called device sheets, and they are intentionally reusable blocks that you can either manage in your Altium 365 workspace, or you can have them in a Concord Pro server if your company uses Concord Pro. But the other thing you can do is have them in a folder on your hard disk. So even if you prefer to stay offline and keep things to yourself, basically not hand all your data and the keys to the kingdom over to Altium for them to host. Nevertheless, sometimes when you have used some of these, you want to be able to convert things back to regular sheets. If I, for example, have this audio amp schematic sheet here, which is one of these reusable device sheets, and I control double click to go into that, you'll see when it opens, it's got a watermark with the reuse symbol and it says read only. And occasionally you might actually want to refactor one of these to say, I don't want to use the reusable block as is. I want to make a copy of it locally to my project and modify it for some reason, perhaps change some of the components in it because of the crazy supply chain situation we're in right now. Well, you can do that with a very useful command called refactor. And all you have to do, I'll show you by way of demo with this schematic sheet, with this JTAG config sheet. You select the sheet symbol and you can simply go to edit, and there's a refactor menu. Now, this used to be on the sheet symbol right click menu. I'll show you in a separate quick tip how to customize the right mouse button menus, the context menus, because that's a very handy thing to do to be able to customize your own workspace. But I can do a few different things here on the refactor. I can not only convert this reusable device sheet into a regular schematic sheet, so I'll do that right now. And it's actually going to create a new schematic document in the project folder based on my selections here in the mode. I can create a schematic sheet from the device sheet and update only the current sheet symbol, or I can create a new one. And if this block has been reused in a multi-channel sense throughout my design in different places or in multiple channels, the top option will do all of them. It will convert all of them to a regular sheet symbol with one underlying schematic document that we can then edit locally to this project. So this allows us to make a local copy and then modify that. And that's what I'll do right now. That local copy then, it removes the watermark. So you know it's no longer a device sheet symbol and you can carry on using it. So just to round out this tip, you might think, where do these device sheet symbols come from? And we've already talked about why you might want to use them. They're good. It's a good way of storing something for reuse. If you get a sensitive analog front end design for an RF microcontroller and you want to reuse that across a number of different products, the device sheet is a really good way to do that. That's just one example. Or a power supply, a regulator circuit might be another one. Or a standardized set of connections like we have here. We used to have these on the nano boards and they were kind of standardized. So we made all of this reusable, and that way it could be put into a library And that could be either your Altium 365 workspace or your local, on your local disk. And then that gives you an easy way to reuse blocks of things without danger of overriding your original pristine source. So that's why you'd want to do it. Now, if I control double click on this JTAG config sheet, it takes me into the child sheet. And here it is. I no longer have the watermark saying it's read only. So I can modify this local copy. So where are device sheets normally stored or how do you create them and use them? So I've got some other things to clean up in this design, as you can see, because every time it validates, it's throwing up the messages panel. Well, let's say I wanted to create a new device sheet from this DBCon. The way to do that is we can actually, we're already in a hierarchical design. An easy way to do that, if you've already designed the schematic and you've got it linked to a sheet symbol for hierarchy, you can select the sheet symbol, and now we have on the edit menu a refactor, and we can convert the selected schematic sheet to a device sheet. And in doing that, it'll create a schematic document that's in my predefined device sheets library folder. Now, in this case, my local device sheets library is defined in an old, or it's in an old path for an older version of Altium Designer that I had on this machine previously. So don't worry about the path name, but that's basically how it is. And there's a few options. We can create a device sheet and update all the references to that same subsheet or subcircuit in the current design to now point to the device sheet, or just the one, or do it for everything in the whole current workspace, or just the local page. Now, I won't go ahead and do this because I actually already do have a device sheet in that location for this folder, so I'm not going to overwrite it. But how do you set where these are stored, these reusable schematic blocks, which are very, very useful? Go into Preferences, go into Data Management, and you'll see there's a Device Sheets Preferences section. So you can specify a path to where all your device sheets are going to go from there. Device sheets are also called managed sheets if you put them in Concord Pro in the server or in your Altium 365 workspace. And so if you're connected to a workspace online, that's not in this preferences page. That's automatically there because you're connected. So that's pretty much all there is to it. Device sheets and refactoring, extremely useful, especially if you do large complex designs or if you have to do a lot of quoting for contract work, and you can build up a library of standardized circuits that you use over and over again, the device sheets is the way to go. And you can very quickly put together a system using top-down hierarchy using this methodology. So definitely check it out. Hope this is helpful. If you liked it, please comment below. If you have any questions, comment below, ask below. And remember to click subscribe, hit the bell icon, so when I release more of these videos, you'll be notified. And I really appreciate you for supporting my channel. Please come back soon. See ya.